Hello and welcome to the class of air pollution and control. In this lecture, we will learn something about the sampling of air. So it is really difficult to collect the true representative air sample, and error may arise which will lead the sampler to wrong conclusion. The methods used for measuring gaseous emission from stack or vent depend on nature of the compound and the purpose of making the measurement, means why we are making this particular measurement of different compounds. The essential requirement or why we need to sample the air might be to calculate the extent of air pollution, or might be to find out the what kind of instrument that is essential for the control of the pollutants those are emitted. The composition and temperature of the carrier gas stream affect the selection of different techniques used for sampling, the different analytical methods associated with it, and a sampling plan too. So as far as the classification of sampling method is concerned, they are depend on sampling for impurities of every nature, means whether we are making the sampling for a particulate matter or gaseous matter or for both. Then sampling under various environmental conditions, ranging from the sample taken from a chimney to sample taken in open air. The sample taken from a chimney might be the case which represents what kind of pollutants a particular industry is emitting and what kind of measures to be taken to restrict the air pollution, while sample taken in an open air might be essential or might be required to calculate how much extent of pollution that is there and what are the measures that needs to be implemented and whether the air quality standards have been followed for that region or not. Again, sampling method varying according to the time factor, means whether how much duration is associated with the sampling, whether the ranging from whether we need to sample it for intermittent case or it will be a sample for the continuous time duration as such. So for example, the continuous sampling may be essential for a certain industrial area where the 24/7 the different manufacturing of different goods might be going on, and 24/7 the activities are somewhere essentially causing the air pollution, while in case of intermittent it might be the case where the 24/7 emission of the gaseous pollutants or particulate matter may not be the case, where we need to calculate the extent of pollution in a particular time frame, in a particular time of a day as such. So to know the difficulties encountered in a sample, the first and the most important thing is that collecting a sample which is true representative, means whether whatever sample we are collecting, whether it is representing the exact nature of the air or the gaseous sample or not. Then second is the error arising from the methods used for the collection and separation of various components of pollution, means whether whatever method we are using is good enough to collect the sample and to separate the various components which are there, different kinds of air pollutants that might be present. So whether we are able to separate it or not. And third is the difficulties in preventing any change in any concentration of particulate matter in suspension as a result of sampling operation, means whatever sampling operation we are taking, whether that sampling operation itself is causing any change in the concentration of different pollutants. So we must take care of all these things while we are taking a sample of an air as such. The primary considerations in those are there in case of air sampling may includes that this is based on the statistical studies, the basic principle of probability to determine the size and frequency of sampling. Second, whether whatever sample we are collecting, is it large enough to make analysis or not. Third, changes in sample during and after sampling, means we must aware that if at all any changes those are happening during the sampling and after the sampling. Then we must aware about the what kind of sampling is essential, whether it needs the continuous sampling or intermittent sampling. Next, a sampling of volatile constituents means whether we are able to preserve that volatile constituents or not. Last and most important is sampling of particulates, may not be a last, apologies. Sampling should be isokinetic as possible. Here the word isokinetic means it should be, a sampling should be followed in such a way that it should be isokinetic, means there should not be a change in overall nature of the sampling as such. The velocity of gas, rather it is more important in case of sampling of gaseous plume that is arising from chimney. So it is more related with the probe inserted, and it should be isokinetic, means that the velocity at which the gaseous stream is getting sampled by the probe should be equivalent to the or equal to the velocity of the gaseous stream from which it is coming out. Then a gas stream should be sampled in the same direction and at the same speed itself. A collection surface should be as close as possible to the source of gas stream. The deposition and condensation should not be allowed to form on the walls of sampling vessels. Then the sampling of waste gas should be sampled at several points, and maximum numbers of samples should be taken. It should not be a sample taken only at the, say, middle or center point of a chimney, as it is a large kind of element or entity. And so we should have a sufficient number of samples taken, which is helpful for providing us the most relevant and exact estimation of different gases those are emitted. Then sampling in open air, it should be a continuous recording, and the continuous recording instrument should be used, and sample should be collected at various places so that we can arise on once again an exact nature of the air pollution extent. The basic consideration of air sampling: the sample collected must be representative in terms of time and location. The sample volume should be large enough to permit accurate analysis. The sampling rate must be such as to provide maximum efficiency of collection. The duration of sampling and frequency should reflect accurately the occurrence of fluctuation in pollution level. The contaminant must not be altered in the process of the collection. As far as instruments are concerned, there are different types of instruments which are generally used to sample the air or gas. The device for general use generally considers the meters, probes and suction devices. While devices for sampling gases and vapors, they include different absorbers, adsorbers, condensers, collectors under reduced pressures and plastic containers. These everything we will going to understand in the next part of this particular presentation. So meters, the meters are used to determine accurately the volume of gas that is collected, and to measure that, generally the meters are fitted with manometer and thermometers. The manometers are used to calculate the exact volume of the glass, while thermometer tells us the exact temperature of that, so that we can come and we can calculate the exactness of the volume of gas at a required temperature. Probes are used for the purpose of calculating the gaseous stream and the